What is up, guys? It is Car Talk with Andre, the only show on the internet where it is called Car Talk, but we do not really talk about cars at all. But just being in here, being isolated in my vehicle, which I love, I just want to express these feelings to you guys. So I'm coming at you with a new video. This video, I want to share with you my number one tip on how to build good habits, but also get rid of bad habits. You can kind of implement it whichever way you like in your life, and it'll work. So what this tip kind of entails, and you'll want to be mindful of the path of least resistance. You may have heard this before. This is kind of essentially how nature works. Like, everything gravitates towards the path of least resistance. And one simple way you can think about this is making the most important decision, like kind of saving your willpower, because there's kind of a currency based on like a time period, or you know, maybe the first thing in the day. You kind of want to save your willpower for the most important thing you can. And this kind of ties into my last video where I talk about getting rid of anxiety and stuff and doing the most important thing first. And this can mean that in a specific way. I'm going to talk a little bit later about some more direct ways we can do this though. But one way, the path of least resistance, you know, saving your willpower, is kind of how Steve Jobs apparently had the same outfit in his closet, you know, kind of like an episode of Doug, if you used to watch Nickelodeon. It's just the same outfit. There is no decision to be made there. So you're kind of saving yourself the willpower, or, you know, just, there's no resistance to making that decision. So you're able to focus your mind on other things. So that's kind of a basic way, but I want to take this more specific. So how can we adapt this into our life for good habits, or bad for getting rid of bad habits? So one way I know on my phone, I found myself getting just bored on social media. Like, one, I was bored, so it was triggering me to open my phone and actually go into social media and just waste a bunch of time in my life. So what I've actually done is put barriers up to make it more difficult to waste that time on social media. So what I did, I move all of my social media apps like to the third page. So I'll have to open my phone, swipe two pages over, go inside a folder, and then go inside another folder to open up Facebook or Instagram, whichever. So just that, those barriers are enough to cut down a lot on the wasted time in social media. And it's surprising how little like abrasiveness you need to put up in order to break habits like that. It's not as much as you'd think. So what I do on the inverse side of things, to build better habits, is on my homepage, I have all of my productivity apps. I have my, you know, spending register, my bank account, my important emails, my to-do list, all of these things which are good productivity hacks. I actually put that on my first list. So, you know, if I'm bored, open up my phone, I probably have something to look at in terms of checking off my checklist, or just reviewing my checklist, going through my important emails, all of that stuff. So I'm setting myself up for success. And I want to transition into my next point, which is where we can also incorporate things more directly for your goals. So what this may look like is kind of making the decision before you're in a position where you may be tempted to make a poor decision or fall into bad habits. So one way, I know, of course, New Year's resolutions are coming up. Everyone wants to lose weight all of a sudden. And one way that you would go about losing weight is, number one, instead of fast food, you'll want to go grocery shopping. That's pretty straightforward, pretty obvious. But not just going to the grocery store. You want to take and make it less abrasive to going towards the grocery store. So number two, sticking to your diet and buying the foods that are in line and aligned with your diet goals. That's a big one too. It's not just going to the store. You'll also need to buy the proper things while you're at the store. You may need to avoid that just expense of walking past all of those treats and those Reese's cups that are just always calling your name, you know? Just don't even look at them. Just don't walk past it. And one way I actually go grocery shopping, I just walk around the perimeter of the entire store, like the outsides. That's where all the stuff you'll need is. You'll find that all the processed shit is actually inside the aisles anyways. So just completely avoid them altogether. And in that way, you're actually setting yourself up for success. And you're also making the decision before you're tempted to make a poor decision. And another thing I want to talk about, of course, people do meal plans, like meal prep. And they'll prepare all their meals for the week, for the day, whichever. You're setting yourself up for success. It's easy for people to stick to their diets. And those are amazing ways to set yourself up for success. So it's not so much just going to the grocery store. You also have to buy the right foods. Number three, you also have to prepare those foods. And for that, for me, it actually means, you know, preparing protein is usually the more difficult parts of meals. So what I do, I have an air fryer. And that makes it super easy for me. I actually have grass-fed steaks, which are mailed to me. So that's even more effortless decisions that I make every month. I just get it sent straight to my house, all the meat that I'll need for the month. It's great. And that's kind of another offside hack there that you can adapt into your lifestyle. And just be mindful of how it works. It's, you know, no decision. It just gets mailed to me every month. It's perfect. But anyways, back on my air fryer. Air fryer is super good. Just throw it in, throw the steak in the air fryer, whatever. I don't have to grease up a pan and fire on the stove. I don't have to fire up a grill and turn the propane on, turn it off. You know, there's no abrasiveness to making those good decisions to be aligned with my goals. So those are just a few things. Think about this a bit more and see how you can adapt things into your life to make it more easy to gravitate towards those right decisions for your goals, to be in alignment, and overall just succeed. So I hope you guys found this tip very insightful. It's one that I notice a lot, and it's just a game changer, man. Once you adapt it into your life and find out what your goals are and find how you can make it easy on yourself to stick to your goals, that's key. So hope you guys enjoyed, and I appreciate all the feedback I've been getting on my channel. I really want to help you guys out and just share some things that I've learned in the past few years. So thank you guys very much. Take care.